Hi friends, in this video we are going to discuss about environment variables in Azure functions. Okay, so the agenda is what environment variables in Azure functions, where to define these variables in Azure functions, and how to read these environment variables from the code in Azure functions. Okay, so actually what is the need of these environment variables? Okay, so there might be cases where you want to store some custom settings for your Azure functions, and you want to read those custom settings, and based upon the setting value you want to control the execution flow of your particular code. Okay, so in such cases, right, you can make use of these environment variables to create those custom settings. Okay, so the one possible available option is to use these environment variables under application settings. Okay, so under application settings you need to define your own variable there with key value pairs, and you need to call those read those values in the code. Okay, I will show you them practically how to do that also. Okay, so people, whenever you define any custom variables in application settings, right, and people used to call them as environment variables. Okay, so this is the sample code. Actually there is a class called environment which has a static method called get environment variable. So you, by using this particular static method, you can read the value of any environment variable which you define in app settings. Okay, let me quickly show you the demo. Let's go to Azure portal. Okay, this is our Azure portal. Okay, if you are following my video series, inside this test environment resource group I have created this function app called demo mahir, right? Let me open this function app, then navigate to configurations. So under configurations you can see application settings. So here there is something called new application setting with plus sign, right? You need to click this to create any new environment variable inside application settings. Okay, I want to name it like environment. This is my variable name. Okay, for example, and I want to give value as development. Okay, click OK. So this will add the variable here. Okay, click show values, it will show the values also. Okay, so once you do that, you need to click this save button. This is updating my settings here. It will take 2 to 3 seconds. Okay, it's done updating web settings, right? Now go back to your function app. So now we add created environment variable, but we want to make use of that variable inside our code, right? So let's quickly write the code there. Let's open this particular function. Okay, once you open this function, what it is doing, it is logging this information, and then it is reading the request URL if there is any query string, or it is reading the request body if there is any value passed with name as name, print that value. So this is what it is doing, right? We have discussed this in our past videos also. So let me quickly run it here also. Okay, we can run these functions within the portal also. We don't need to take the URL and perform HTTP trigger. You can run directly here also. Let me show you that. Once you click this run button, it will execute actually. But if you see here, what it is actually doing is, it is issuing a HTTP GET request, and it is passing a query string in the URL with value as name for name. Okay, and it is executing that, right? So now let's scroll down. You can see the output here. See, the function executed and it printed hello Mahir. And also you can see here, it is logging that, right? C# HTTP trigger function processed a request. So from where this is logging it, this is logging it from here. If you see the code, let me scroll up. If you see the code here, log information, C# HTTP trigger function processed a request. So this is what it is logging here, right? Okay, let's do one thing. We have created an environment variable called environment, right? Let me write a code to read the value of that particular variable and print it here. Okay, for now. Okay, so let me immediately here. Okay, I have pasted the code. What it is doing, it is logging again under system environment class get environment variable method. I am passing the variable name what I want. So my variable name is environment, right? So I am passing that. And there is another argument which you need to pass, that is the target. This environment variable target process, this is the current process, this we have to pass. So what it should do, it should print this line and then it should print here development, because we have set value for this particular variable as development in our app settings, right? So it should print development here. Okay, so let me quickly save this code and run it on fly. So it is executing. Okay, it seems execution done. Let's scroll down. Okay, it printed hello Mahir here output. Let's see the log. Okay, compiled successfully our code, then execution started. Okay, then C sharp HTTP trigger function process request printed that. You can see this. See, this is printing like development. From where this value is coming? Because we are reading the environment variable called environment using this particular method, and it is, we are getting the value of that particular variable, and that is development. Get it, right? So this way you can define your custom settings in environment variables, and you can make use of those values inside your code. Mostly people, what they will do is, like, if it is development environment, then execute something, or else execute something else. So such kind of flows, execution flows, you can define. Okay, hope this gives a clear idea about environment variables. Thank you, friends. Please subscribe to my channel and press bell icon to get any notifications whenever I add videos. Thank you so much.